All right, folks, we are inside the brand new Hyundai Kona N, and this is one of the vehicles that we are considering doing a file page on because I really think it's an exciting car that a lot of you should know more about. 276 horsepower with available 280 plus on tap for 20 seconds with an overboost feature, front wheel drive, tons of space, super fun, and relatively practical to drive day to day. So without further ado, here are the keys. Let's go for a spin. All right, here she is, the 2022 Hyundai Kona N. Now, this is the most premium car in Hyundai's N lineup with a base price at around $34,000. But Hyundai made a lot of changes to this Kona to differentiate it from the vehicle that you currently know. That large wing, that diffuser, the painted fenders instead of black plastic, the unique wheels that leverage a specific compound of Pirelli tire for the Kona N, bigger brakes, we're talking about 14.2-inch rotors in the front. And underneath the hood, you're looking at a 2-liter turbocharged engine that makes 276 horsepower, but can be overboosted to well over 280. Thanks to these bolstered seats, they do a great job at keeping you planted but comfortable. These are a different seat than you would find in the Elantra N or Veloster N, and I kind of like it that way because they're a little bit more comfortable. Sit in those nice seats and you are greeted with a similar LCD screen to what we saw in the Santa Cruz and a large navigation screen with physical buttons. Hooray! That was one of the big knockers we had on the Santa Cruz. Add to that some heated seats, and you have all the features you would want in a daily driver. But let's go to the back seat to see how much room this compact SUV has. Again, for all our back seat tests, we sit behind ourselves, which means we're sitting behind a 6-foot tall human being, and I have no leg room. My legs are touching the seat, but I do have a little bit of headroom, which is nice, and a padded armrest for my right hand or left, depending on which side I'm sitting in. As we get back in, though, I'm going to toss you guys the keys. Well, you guys already have the keys. Who am I kidding? Let's go for a rip in the Kona N and see what we think about Hyundai's fast SUV. As we take a right out of this lot, I'm going to have you guys give it the beans and see, notice this transmission, notice the torque steer, and notice the power. Here we go. Traction control kicks in a little bit, makes sense. We're looking at 30 degrees roughly during the timing of this video, which means it's boost weather, but it also means that summer tires just aren't really cut out for this temperature, so we're gonna get a lot of slippage over the course of this video. As we get up to speed though, one of the things we notice about the Kona N is its ability to be comfortable, is its ability to hold the road remarkably well. For a vehicle that was tailored around the Nürburgring and is a sporty vehicle, it really does hold its own in a highway-like setting. One of the things you will notice, however, is there is a little bit of wind noise coming in here, but if you've listened to, if you've watched the Maverick files, it is a relatively similar level of road noise to what you experience in the Ford Maverick. Look at how beautiful this screen is, guys. I just cannot get over the fact that as you switch through, as you bang through all these modes, it just does such a good job at not only changing your entire experience, but it does so quickly. There's no lag. This thing is really, really cool. And in normal mode, as we are right now, just putt-putting around town, it does a great job. You don't hear that exhaust, which, by the way, is an active exhaust. We'll get to that in a second. You don't really feel much of the bumps. It's definitely a stiffer suspension than, say, that Corolla in front of us, but it's still something that's relatively nice to drive. But let's see the duality of the Kona N as we hit sport mode, okay? So you notice the red on the dash. We're gonna slow down here, click a couple downshifts, and then I want you guys to give it the beans, and I want you to hit that red button, which enables the overboost feature, okay? Let's do it. Hit the gas. Let's see what she's got. Nice upshift with the little pop bang. You saw the traction control light kick in there. Bang a couple of downshifts as we take this turn a lot slower than we normally would, given the conditions, let's be honest. And let's accelerate out of this corner here. Snappy upshifts. This car is just a ton of fun. And as we go back to this sort of around town portion, I want you guys to look at the duality
of this Kona N, we went from just banging gears and taking turns at a decent rate of speed to now putt-putting around town, limited noise. The moment you switch this thing into eco or into normal, you really don't hear much. Hyundai does a great job at changing the personality of this car. If this vehicle had a cancer sign, it would be Gemini, because it is very dual personal in terms of how it operates. Hyundai did a really, really good job at that. This car can be an around town cruiser, but it can also be a weekend car that you sort of let your hair down with, and I love it. So, all right, let's give it the beans off this green light and see how she does. A little bit of torque steer, a little bit of spin. Remember, it is cold. These are summer tires. But yeah, I cannot stress enough how hilariously fun this car is, and it really feels like it shouldn't be. One of the things we talk about whenever we do these quick blasts and competitors, these quick blasts, is its competitors, and the Hyundai doesn't really have many. Think about what performance SUVs can you think about for under $40,000. They don't really exist, and because of that, this car is in a class of its own. Now, what are the main drawbacks to the Hyundai Kona? Well, it is that space, right? This thing is a little bit smaller in the rear seat than something like a Ford Maverick or a Bronco Sport or a Ford Escape, but what you lose in space, you gain in personality. And I gotta read you guys a direct quote that someone wrote in a comment thread about the Kona N that I think perfectly encompasses folks' feelings about Hyundai. Quote, some people are never satisfied. There are already folks complaining about the price when there isn't a single vehicle on the market more capable for less money. People complained that the Veloster wasn't practical, so Hyundai responded by giving them the same engine and drivetrain in an SUV, and yet it's not good enough. And that's where I don't want you guys to fall into the same loop, okay? What we're getting in the Kona N is a turbocharged active exhaust, dual clutch transmission SUV. This thing has all the practicality of an SUV in terms of space. This thing has decent levels of efficiency. And as we go back to the outside view, it's got damn good looks. I'm sorry, this Kona N looks sharp, especially in this rally red configuration. So as we wind down what potentially might be the first video of our next file car, I leave you with this. What Hyundai generated by producing the 2022 Kona N was giving you a vehicle that could not only be mild-mannered around town, but could let its hair down and have a ton of fun on a weekend road, all the while bringing you a family. Bringing you a family? No. Bringing your family with you. And that, my friends, is a testament to what Hyundai's N division is doing. That, my friends, is a testament to the direction that Hyundai's N line is going. You can not only get a vehicle like the Veloster N that is slightly impractical, but looks great and is a ton of fun. You get a mid-grade vehicle in the Elantra N, which offers you sedan levels of practicality and a similar drivetrain. But you could also get a vehicle like this that offers you compact SUV practicality, but all the fun of a hot hatch. So kudos to you, Hyundai. And let me know in the comments, what do you think? Should we add a Kona N to the fleet and give you guys a full file page rundown? Let me know. See you next time.